It's the Tome Show! Science is easy when the Tome Show does it. Let's learn about transposable elements. Transposable elements make up approximately 44% of the human genome. Mutations caused by transposable elements are linked to cancer and other diseases.
Transposable elements, or transposons, are jumping genes named for their ability to move to another position in the genome. There are two classes of transposable elements, each with unique ways of moving. One is the retrotransposon and the other is a DNA transposon.
The retrotransposon moves via a copy and paste method. And the DNA transposon moves by a cut and paste method.
Retrotransposons are transposable elements that move via the copy and paste method.
First, the retrotransposon gets itself copied. There are two genetic languages, DNA and RNA. You can think of DNA as the main blueprint of life, while RNA is the messenger of life, carrying the blueprint to other parts of the cell. The retrotransposon gets the help of the enzyme RNA polymerase to be transcribed or copied into RNA. But the problem is, if the retrotransposon is to be inserted into a new region of DNA, it can't be in RNA. It needs to be in DNA. So the RNA is reverse transcribed into DNA using reverse transcriptase. Now the copied DNA must be pasted into the new part of the genome. Please bear in mind that it is not yet fully understood how the copied DNA is pasted. The target site is where the new copy is inserted. The enzyme integrase cuts the target site, making staggered breaks, or cuts at opposite ends. The retrotransposon is finally pasted in. The remaining gaps are repaired by replicating the DNA on opposite sides using DNA polymerase. Another enzyme called DNA ligase glues the segments together.
And that's how the retrotransposon is copied and pasted into a new region of the genome. And what's more interesting about this transposable element is that it is very similar to a type of virus called the retrovirus. An example of a retrovirus is HIV. Many people don't know that they have HIV until a few years after getting infected, because HIV can stay dormant in their genomes in this way. We've talked about retrotransposons, but what about DNA transposons? These transposable elements move via a cut and paste method.
The DNA transposon is cut out by the enzyme transposase. It is shaped into a hairpin structure to be pasted into the target site. The transposon attacks and inserts itself into the target site. Do you remember our friends DNA polymerase and DNA ligase? They're back again to fill the gaps and glue it all up. In summary, the retrotransposon is copied and pasted into the target site through the processes of transcription and reverse transcription. The DNA transposon is cut and pasted into the target site by being changed into the hairpin structure.
Now, can it be any easier or sweeter? Thanks for watching!